Maseari watu wote. Maseari. Yeah, we have to know all these languages. Good morning, friends and colleagues. Like it was mentioned, I'm Masukwa Chirizi. I'm sector manager working with the Thando Victim Empowerment Program. And I'm managing the trauma centers and the access to justice cluster. So I'm honored to be presenting today on the buddy system as a promising strategy to support the PP compliance amongst the survivors of sexual assault. So I'm also happy to be presenting on behalf of my sisters and brothers who also work in deep rural villages. Just to give you a background of the Thando Victim Empowerment Program. We are located in the Tulamela municipality, and we are right in Limpopo province, South Africa. So our neighboring countries is Botswana, Mozambique, as well as Zimbabwe. So we are just close to the Zimbabwean border. And our message is clear. There's no excuse for abuse. And our mission is to generate an attitude of zero tolerance towards all forms of sexual assault, domestic violence, child abuse, and HIV and AIDS stigmatization in the villages where we are operating. And also, to give you some of the context of where we work, the Bembe district has a population of almost 600,000 people, and mostly they are Venda and Shangans indigenous people. And a very large percentage of our population is under the age of 18 years, meaning most of our clients are minors. And 55% of our population, they are women and girls. So the majority of our clients are young children, the adolescents and women. So we are also faced with some challenges that makes it difficult for us to offer quality services. The first challenge is the jurisdiction itself, the area itself. Our area is mountainous, and it is difficult for people to access basic services. And also there is a shortage of transport. The other challenge is that we live in a patriarchal society, and where men and boys are considered the most important members of the community. So women are regarded as minors, whether you are 30 years old or you are 50 years old, but you are still a minor. So another challenge is that each village has got their own chief who uses his own way of governing. Like for instance, tradition is interpreted in so many ways, and some of the traditions don't support human rights. So that's another challenge. So, and finally, we've got the high levels of HIV and AIDS stigma, making it difficult for people living with HIV and AIDS to access treatment and also to come up for services because of fear. So to address these shortfalls, STVP, we've developed 9 programs. And in these programs, we use community engagement and partnerships building to ensure that our interventions are successful. So our implementing partners include the king, the chiefs, because they are the custodians of culture. So we want to brainwash them first. And also other partners, there is the civil society organizations, our religious leaders, the police, the departments of health and social development, and as well as the community liaison officers. So throughout the program, what we do is to offer the rights-based knowledge and empowerment to every member of the society, from small children up until to the grandmothers. So what we're trying to do is to cover almost everyone in the community. Because we know if we target our small children, they are our future leaders. And also, our goal is to cover almost everyone and to give each and everyone the individual capacity and agency to know their rights, and not just to know their rights and exercise those rights, because there is difference between knowing your rights and claiming your rights. So we are empowering even women to go out and claim and exercise those rights that they are entitled to. This has resulted in most victims seeking justice against their perpetrators. And as a result, we've created safer communities in the area where we are working. So, like for instance, there is a change of perception on men towards women and children. I mean, for us, it's a success to see a chief, to see a king demonstrating a female condom. So they are encouraging their own communities to use male and female condoms. And they take pride in knowing that they contributed to those changes in perception in their communities. And this makes the program sustainable because it's owned by the community. Just also to give you a history about our body system, which I'm talking about today. This body system we use in all cases of sexual assault and domestic violence, as well as child abuse, that are managed by our organization, TVEP. So since we've opened the trauma centers in 2001, we've assisted almost 17,000 clients. So this program was developed because of the response to the high incidence of sexual assault and the low rate of PEP completion among our clients and countrywide. So on average countrywide, we've got 31 to 38% of PEP completion. Some places only report 15% completion of PEP. So we thought that if we can come up with a strategy that can intervene, maybe to increase the PEP compliance, then that will be effective. So what we did as an organization was to train our own survivors, our own staff on the body system. So those people, they encourage, you know, the survivors of sexual assault to adhere to PEP intake so that at the end of the day they comply with the prescription. And so because we realized that at the past we used peer support models and it was working for us, so we wanted to follow the very same route so that we could come up with the positive results that we are aiming in our villages. So every month we are seeing 30 to 40% new cases of sexual assault. And on top of that, we've got a serious deadlock because it takes almost 4 to 5 years for just one rape case to be finalized in court. So you could imagine if every month we are having new cases, almost 30 to 40% is a lot. And on top of that, we also have got new cases of hundreds of new cases of domestic violence every month that are reporting to our trauma centers. So that's why the reason why we are using this body system, maybe to assist in the intervention that we've come up with. So the body system has resulted in positive results, and in the cases that were reported from March 2013 to February 2014, we have an average PEP compliance rate of 78% just in our area, in our region, as compared to the national statistic, which is 31 to 38%. So for us, that's an achievement. So maybe the question that one can ask himself or herself is how does the body system work? So how the system works is very simple. when a survivor of sexual assault reports to one of our trauma centers, we immediately assign a buddy. So this person is trained in all aspects of post-rape trauma, and their main role is to advocate on the victim case until it is finalized in court. And the intervention, amongst others, includes a collection of rape kit, police report, HIV counseling, full 28 PP regimen, provision of antibiotics, provision of food parcels, provisions of care kit, and children are provided with the comfort coils, and the buddy conducts home visit, the buddy does phone call check-in, the buddy is always there for the victim 24/7. And the buddy also facilitates the follow-up appointments and transport. These are the follow-up with our trauma counselor, and also follow up in terms of the retest. So the buddy also support the victim through the, when she journeys through the criminal justice system. So that's why maybe if you can check those circles, the victim is in red there. But at the end of the day, she becomes a survivor and she's shining. So that's one of our main objectives, to turn a victim into a survivor. Yeah, over the 12-month period, 564 cases of sexual assault were presented to TVEP, and of those, 408 were eligible for PEP, if you can see there, based on their HIV status and the type of the sexual assault. So 16.5% of our survivors are under the age of 10 years. And additionally, 43.8% clients are between the ages 10 and 19 years. So over 60% of our sexual assault survivors are adolescents and children. 87.3% of those eligible to begin a PEP started their treatment, and of those, 356 clients began PEP, and 78 completed the full 28 regimen. And completion is monitored by ongoing adherence, and home visits provided by the body, as well as the counting of pills. And with the help of from our friend Ilona from the University of Oxford, we're able to look at the association between the services that are offered by TVP and the body system, as well as completion of PEP. And attending the first and the second counseling sessions were associated with PEP completion, and receiving shelter was not a significant factor, but receiving any other kind of support like food parcels, care kits, and antiemetics was a significant factor. So in future, we'd like to analyze each of these components more individually so that we can learn more. So if you are also interested in the analysis, maybe you can see me after the presentation. I can share the analysis with you. And also, we've got some materials, information about our organization, which I can also give them to you. So, in closing, I'm saying thanks to our victim advocacy, the buddies, and the trauma center staff, and the South African police, the Department of Health and Social Development, our implementing partners, and a special thanks to our friends in the African and regional on gender-based violence network, with whom we share best practices across sub-Saharan Africa. So in closing, let me say, what concerns you concerns me, and united we stand. Thank you.